Wasn't enough.
I'm Indigo Man. I was born a superstar. Everybody in the band loves the DNA.
What's up, BB? Mar Pacific Palisades, California, where I grew up. I'm 19 years old, and basically, I'm the jerking entrepreneur. Before New Boys, before the Rangers, before anybody, we were the first to hit 1 million views. Jerking, basically, it was African-American thing. One of my friends and I were just like, let's post a video. You know, it's supposed to be a jerking video. There was maybe a few jerk videos, but not many at all. And I don't even think I had seen any, really. First met the original UCLA Jerk Kings at UCLA frat parties. We kind of met through seeing each other jerk. We did that completely for fun. We had no idea it was going to get viral or anything. And, you know, right now we're at, like, almost 4 million views. And he's the only white boy doing it. So, like, you don't have to type in what the actual video he named it. Just type in white boy jerk. And that's it. And I was like, oh. And he was, like, better than me. I couldn't even dance at the time. I was like, oh, dang. But there was no other white jerkers when I first posted my video. When I jerked and I was okay at it, I was known as, like, the best white jerker.
His style was definitely different. I would say the white version of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
I would go to parties or some jerking events, like after a video became somewhat viral. I was still known as like the white kid that was known to be good at dancing. Some people would be like, wow, like, would appreciate me, and then some people would be like, where'd this kid grow up?
But there was one dude in the center of like the whole dance, and it was this dude, and he was getting on.
All of a sudden, promoters and club throwers saw me and they're like, you know, do you want to perform for my party? A while after I started UCLA Jerk Kings, I got into actually throwing the party, and I had promoters, you know, working for me.
I love this jerking movement, and, you know, I really decided I want to be the jerking entrepreneur.
Well, I'm addicted to what? You know, I don't drink. I'm addicted to what? I don't pop pills. I'm addicted to what?
These are babies, our inner animals. What's up, guys? How are you? So what's up with the Fox Hills? I don't know why you guys don't have them in yet. How sick. You can be in the wild. You can have your inner animal right on you. I want to dominate in music, in acting. I want to have the biggest clothing line out. So every kid is wearing them around town. I mean, we have Soulja Boy. We have some of the like hippest people in hip-hop, in entertainment business, rocking them. Yeah, we have BB the Jerk. I want to be in Forbes magazine, chilling next to Oprah and the Queen. I'm going to show you how to dance with the tails on. Go like this, and you jump, boom, sleep, boom. Now put the right back, weight on the right. Now do the same thing. We got to make a deal. I got every color you want, every color of the rainbow. I even have a rainbow colored one.
I want to entertain people, just like my family does. My grandfather, who is a manager, he actually managed, you know, Jerry Lewis, Mickey Rooney.
He was known as actually making the worst movies in show business. He didn't mind that, you know, he kind of bragged about that. He actually won awards, I think, for having the worst movies, and one of the worst movies that he ever made was called Bela Lugosi and the Brooklyn Gorilla.
Getting ready to go into the screening of my grandfather's documentary that my mom's been working on for 4 years, and I'm pretty excited because he's a really big inspiration to me.
This kind of movie incorporates like a bunch of interviews from comedians and actors that he worked with.
My dad was always up on the newest craze when twisting was coming into style, and he said, get your guys to put up some money, we'll make a movie, we'll be twisting, it's the newest thing. Now Barnaby starts jerking this dance, and suddenly I hear my son is famous on the internet. He was on it first, like his grandfather.
My goal is to honestly go in front of a group of kids and like speak, and yeah, their ears are actually open to what I have to say, because when I think of influential people, when I listen to what they have to say, like, I actually listen. I mean, I enjoy being, you know, the forefront of white jerkers and the forefront of jerkers, period. That's what I want to do, you know. I plan on being a billionaire, you know. What's time when I'm like 25.
She wants me. Slow romance fills the air. I can't help but feel.